In this video and the next two videos, I want to develop elementary integration formulas. These will be the building blocks for doing integrating any function. In this video, we'll derive the midpoint rule. I'll show you how to derive all of these elementary formulas from Taylor series expansions. So here we want to derive a formula for doing an integral. I'll call it I sub h, which will be the integral from 0 to h of f of x dx. Okay? That's kind of a building block integral that we can use then to integrate, say, from a to b. To derive the midpoint rule, we Taylor series expand f of x about the midpoint of the interval, which is h over 2. So we write f of x equals f of h over 2 plus x minus h over 2, f prime of h over 2, right? So just a Taylor series expansion, plus x minus h over 2 squared over 2 factorial, which is 2, times f double prime of h over 2. I'm going to include more terms than we need here because we'll need them later, so I might as well do them all now. So we have plus x minus h over 2 cubed over 3 factorial, which is 6, times f third derivative at h over 2, plus x minus h over 2 to the fourth over 4 factorial, which is 24, times the fourth derivative, 1, 2, 3, 4 of h over 2. Okay, so we'll do carry all these terms. So we substitute this into the integral. So we have I sub h equals the integral from 0 to h. We put this in for f of x, right? And I want to change variables here. So we're going to let y equals x minus h over 2. So dy equals dx. And that will allow us to write the integral then. The lower limit becomes minus h over 2. The upper limit becomes h over 2. And then everywhere there's an x minus h over 2, we put in a y. So we have some term here with all y's, dy. Okay? And at this point, we can simplify because this is an integral over a symmetric interval from minus h over 2 to h over 2. So all the odd powers of y will go to 0, right? Integral of an odd function over a symmetric integral equals interval equals 0. All the even powers of y will be an integral from 0 to h over 2 multiplied by 2. So let me write that here. So this will give us twice the integral from 0, h over 2, right? So from minus h over 2 to h over 2 goes to twice from the integral from 0 to h over 2. And then we have an f of h over 2. And then the odd power of y, x minus h over 2 becomes y, that goes to 0. And then we have this even power here, so plus y squared over 2, f double prime of h over 2. This odd power here also goes to 0. And then we have this even power plus y to the fourth over 24, f fourth derivative of h over 2. And all that dy, okay? And dropping all the higher order terms. Okay, so we need some integrals here. We need the integral from 0 to h over 2 of y squared dy. That's y cubed over 3 from 0 to h over 2, which becomes h cubed divided by 24. Right? The other integral we need is y to the fourth. So the integral from 0 to h over 2 y to the fourth dy becomes y to the fifth over 5 from 0 to h over 2, which is h to the fifth. And then the denominator here is 5 times 2 to the fifth, which works out to 160. Okay? So we've done the y squared integral and the y to the fourth integral. And then we multiply by 2, we divide by 2, we divide by 24. So we get our result here. So we get I sub h is equal to h times 2 times h over 2 times f of h over 2. So h times f of h over 2. That's the midpoint rule, the leading order term here. And then the error terms are the higher order. So we have plus h cubed over 24 times f double prime of h over 2. And then the last term will be plus h to the fifth over 1920, the fourth derivative of f at h over 2. And then, of course, there are higher order terms that we drop. So this is the midterm rule. Usually you write that as h times f of h over 2 plus the error, the local error here, which we use the notation big O of h cubed. That means the leading order term here goes like h cubed. The midpoint rule, very simple actually. We approximate the integral from 0 to h of f of x dx time as h times the value of f at the midpoint of the interval, h times f of h over 2. This is an elementary formula. We'll do two more, and then we'll see how useful they can be in deriving formulas for integrating a function from A to B. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.